Hi, good morning students. So in last class we are studying the fourth chapter, presentation on data. So in that we have completed a certain course, and last class we discussed about a bar diagram. In that we studied about a simple bar diagram. So bar diagram is equispaced, equivalent and rectangular bar. So the size of the bar should be of same size, or the rectangular bar should be the same size, and gap between each rectangular bar is a should be the same. That's why it's called equispaced rectangular bar. So last class we have seen the individual rectangular bars, where it's called as a simple bar diagram. Now we are going to see the multiple bar diagram. So here we have a data of two or more sets. If you are conducting any survey or census, we not collect about only one information. For example, we have conducted a census. So we collect the information of our population, we collect the information of our location where they are living, like urban and rural people, and we also collect the information of their educational status, whether they are literates or illiterates, and we also collect the information into the occupation, what kind of a work they are doing for their livelihood. So we are collect the information about the multiple variables. So when we are presenting the data, so sometimes we have to present the information in a multiple variables. That's why we use the multiple bar diagrams. Here we have more than two set of data. Simple bar diagram is we have only one set of information. But here we have more than two set of information. Our data used to compare it, like our income and expenditure of a household in a different month. So income and expenditure we can take. So household we can take income and expenditure, and we can also take import and export of our country in a different years. Import and export of our country, which is also can we can present in a multiple bar diagram, and also we can say because marks in a different subject in a different tests. So we are conducting a many tests in a one academic year, and you are writing a different marks, you are writing a different subjects. So we can present that in also a multiple diagram. So that is called as a multiple diagram. Here I am taking an example. So the example is showing the income and expenditure of a household in a different month. Sorry, it's not a household, it's a household. So income and expenditure of a one household, a family, we can take a family in the place of a household in a different month. So here our unit of measurement is a thousand. What I written on a table, it is in a thousands. So here we have a data of 6 months from January to June. So in the second column, I'm showing the income of the family household, and the third column is the expenditure of a household. Here the 25 means it is not 25,000. Why means we have written the unit of measurement in the title of the table. That's why it's applicable to the whole table. So here 25 means a 25,000. 22 means a 22,000. So here I classify the data in the table. Now I presented this information in a table. Sorry, in a directory. So here we have a month. The month is an independent variable. That's why I am presenting a number of x axis. So here I am presenting a month. So here income and expenditure is a dependent variable. That's why I am presenting in a y axis. So here income and expenditure. So how we are presenting? We are presenting in a thousand. So we have to mention thousands. So income and expenditure in a thousand. So if you take the month January, so income of the consumer, income of the household is a 25,000, and the expenditure is a 50. So both are related. So here I have this one. This rectangle, whole this one represents the month. So whole this two rectangular bars also represents the month. So here the one rectangular bar representing the income of a household, another rectangular bar is expressing the expenditure of a household. That's why I have given a different color for a bar. So the bulk of the rectangle drawn with the crossed line are showing the expenditure of a household. How much it is? It is a 15,000. It is a 15,000. Income is a 25,000. Income is a 25,000. I hope you are clear. So here we have two rectangular bars for the jumper because these two data is related to the jumper. So 25,000 is the income in a jumper of a household. 15,000 is the expenditure of a household in a jumper. So that represents the jumper. That's why we are written together. Then we have a space and we are written the data of February. So income of the household in a February is 30,000. Expenditure is a 27,000. So it is 30. This one is a 20. So here we can compare it. If you observe these two rectangular bars, here the income is more than a expenditure. Here also income is a more than the household expenditure. So in the month of March 25, income is a 25,000, expenditure is a 22,000. So in the month of April, income is a 20,000, expenditure is a 25,000. In the month of May, income is 35,000, expenditure is 20,000. In the month of June, income is 40,000, expenditure is 25,000. If anyone asks the question, when you see this diagram, you can easily compare with the income of a household and the expenditure of a household. So why we can looking at the April? If you look at the April, there is income exceeds. Expenditure exceeds the income. So expenditure is more than income. Expenditure is more than income. How we are saying this? Because the expenditure rectangular bar is more than income rectangular bar. So income rectangular bar is ended in the 20. Expenditure rectangular bar is 25,000. So it's more lengthier than the income bar. That's why we can say their expenditure is more than income. In all other rectangular bars, in all other months rectangular bars of income and expenditure, there is income exceeding than expenditure. Clear? So after writing all this in a separate bar, here we have to show which one is representing the income and which one is representing the expenditure. So the empty rectangular bars are showing the income of household. Empty rectangular bars are showing the income of household. And the rectangular bar with a crossed line are showing the expenditure of household. Expenditure of household. Expenditure of household. This is your multiple bar diagram. If you see the multiple bar diagram, they are presenting more than two set of data for a comparing. So income and expenditure are related variables. For comparing, we are using a multiple bar diagram. Examples, we can take income and expenditure, import and export, your marks in a different subject in different tests. So here I am taking an example of an income and expenditure of a household. It's a family's expenditure and income in a different months. I am presenting the information in a thousands. So here we have information of the 6 months and income of the 6 months, expenditure of the 6 months, and all the data I have presented in a graph. So the empty rectangular bar that represents the income of a household, rectangular bar with a crossed line is representing the expenditure of a household. So by seeing this, we can understand there is in a many months income is exceeding the expenditure. In a many months, except the April, always everywhere income is more than his family's expenditure. In a month of April, expenditure exceeds the income. So this is your multiple bar diagram, and finally you have to draw it, you have to show here. So what should the rectangular, empty rectangular bar is representing? What is the rectangular bar with a cross line is representing? So empty rectangular bar is representing the income of household. Rectangular bar with a cross line is showing the expenditure of household. This is the multiple bar diagram. Thank you.